Which statement is not correct? Very clearly, the first one here is wrong. There is no such thing as an event handling class. There are really two things that you need to do in order to get event handling to work with Swing. You need to implement the action listener interface, and the listener needs to be registered with the control. First of all, we will really look at this, what is called an action event. There are different types of events that can happen in Swing, but action event is the most common one. You have seen mouse event and key event already. Action event is the most common one, and also probably the easiest to handle, and so this is why we cover this here first. Almost all components have this action event. A button, when it's clicked, throws an action event, fires an action event, a checkbox when being checked or unchecked, a menu when it's clicked, when you enter, when you press enter on a text field, then an action event is triggered. So many of the components that you have seen have this action event associated with it. And I think it's probably best if we just go through a real example. What we want to create here is a JButton object. And when this is clicked, we want this to generate an action event object, and that action event object then in turn is handled by the action listener, so it's handed over to the action listener. Here in graphical representation, the button is clicked, and there's the class MyActionListener, which is an action listener. It is registered with the button, and when the button is clicked, then it creates this action event object and hands it over to the MyActionListener class by calling this action performed method in the MyActionListener class. For this to happen, we need to do four different things. The first two you are already familiar with. First of all, we need to create that component, for example, a JButton. You would have seen how to do this in the previous session. Also then, we need to add this component to an appropriate container, for example, to a JPanel. Again, you would have seen this earlier. This is also where the layout manager may come in. Next then, and this is the new thing about events, we need to register a listener with the component, so that the component actually knows where to send this new action event. And the fourth thing then is to actually define a callback method. So in the action listener, there needs to be a method called action performed, and that is then called when the event is triggered, when the component receives the event and generates an action event object. It calls this action performed method in the listener class. This can be represented like this. Look here, that would be an events sample app. This is what we are going to produce here. And within that event sample app, there is a JButton. The JButton, even by default, contains such an addActionListener method, and in this way we can now add a new class, MyActionListener, to the button. We can say whenever an event occurs, call the MyActionListener object. But as I said, there's two things. Looking back at this, we need to register the listener, but we also need to define a callback method, and this happens here in the action listener. Action performed is defined in my action listener class, and this is actually because it implements this interface called ActionListener. The interface ActionListener prescribes that you need to have a method called ActionPerformed. Here is a slightly different way of representing the same thing. Instead of these two classes here, the MyActionListener class that implements the ActionListener interface, we could also just describe this with this little bullet here, a shorthand for implements ActionListener. Good, now let's look how this would actually look on code level.